Hey guys, and welcome to Nomadic Dmitry channel. In the previous two videos, we have been discussing installing different versions of Linux on top of the M1 Mac, just basically running those on the virtual machines. So the option I used to virtualize Linux on M1 chip was Parallels, and you can see this is the first option right here. And Parallels is fine, it's a good option, it works really fast, it's good, there's even support available, so because it's a paid application, that's why support available, and most likely you're gonna be fine just running this solution. But there are two main problems with Parallels. So the first problem is that it only allows you to run ARM. So basically you can only run ARM images on your computer, on your Mac. You can install Debian ARM, like Ubuntu ARM, Windows ARM, but only those. So it's not possible to install anything else. And the second problem is that the Parallels is paid one, right? So you need to actually pay for Parallels, for upgrades and for all that stuff. So I mean, not everyone likes to pay for the application. That's why there are other options available. If we talk about alternative solutions the Parallels, which are available, most of them are based on QEMU, and I basically highlighted this right here. If we talk about alternative solutions, it's possible to boot into x86 environment, so like it's possible to install like Windows XP, Windows 7, Windows 10, x86 version just fine, but of course there'll be some drawbacks in terms of the speed, so the speed is not gonna be that great, because it basically emulates completely different CPU type, but in Parallels, it's actually just using the same CPU type, right, ARM to ARM, so there is no conversion, but of course if there are version, like there's a huge speed loss, but still, I mean, it's quite possible to run those. That's why let's discuss those options, because sometimes you actually need to run those virtual machines. So QEMU is like a backend. It's just like basically hypervisor that you can use for different solutions. For example, my favorite one is UTM. UTM is like a front end that you can install. It basically uses the QEMU as a backend engine, and it works just fine. So let me actually show you the official website. So if you go there on the UTM website and the GitHub page, it basically provides you information how to install this one. One of my favorite things about UTM is that you can also install this one not only on your Mac, because it says DMG image, right? But you can also install IPA, and IPA is iOS file, right? It's basically you can install it on your iOS device, on your iPad or iPhone. You can technically run like Windows XP on your mobile device, which is, I guess, cool, but I mean, I'm not sure about the actual value of that, but it's actually possible to run it. So you can use this option as well. And DMG file is the one you need to go if you want to install it on your Mac machine. And if you go to another website, they have basically UTM website where you can actually download this one, like simplified version, like not a GitHub page. So if you go to that website and you go to gallery page, it actually provides you with ready solutions, for example, the React OS. And you can just grab this image and you can use it in UTM. So that's what I basically did, and I'm gonna show you to you right now. So you can just explore the gallery for more solutions, and if you scroll down here, you can see, for example, yes, Windows XP, and it says Architecture x64. So you can basically download this one. I mean, you still need to have an image of Windows XP, actual image, and here you download like a template to install all that in your hypervisor. Basically like a template with all the instructions, with all the settings to run this one on your computer. So yeah, you can just grab this one from here. So after you're done with installation of Windows XP in your virtual machine, you just need to install the Spice tools. And Spice tools is just like a guest tool. For example, similar to what we have in VirtualBox, let's say, right? So you install the guest tools, and it allows, for example, to accelerate the graphic performance, the clipboard interaction between guest and host and stuff like that. So basically you just need to install those tools. So you can have a virtual machine with Windows XP running on your M1 Mac. Of course, there's gonna be some speed problems, but it's still gonna be working. So I'm just gonna launch the UTM application, and I already have this image right here, React OS. So I basically download this image and just double clicked on that, and it automatically added this one to the UTM profile right here. That's how the interface looks like. So basically just like a front end for the QEMU for running x86 images. And I have React OS right here. I just double clicked on the image provided on the website and just downloaded this image, and it was automatically there. Let's go ahead and actually launch this one. Let's see how it works. All right, React OS, let's run this one. And it seems to be working actually quite fine. Like, look at that. But probably there are some issues. I think so. It must be, because it's like a total conversion of from M1 chip to x86 platform, and there should be some speed issues, I guess, but so far so good, I guess. And this is like a typical React OS stuff. What I actually noticed, for example, if I open some file like readme, and then for example I try to drag it around, I was having some graphical problems right here, but now it seems to be actually quite fine. Seems to be not that bad, guys. It still feels a bit slow when you like drag around. around the Windows like that, but I guess it's like manageable actually, it's not that bad. Of course it's gonna be slower on Windows 7 or Windows 10, but seems to be quite manageable, right? Let's see if it loads. And yeah, it seems to be loading the web page. It's a bit slow, as I said, it's total conversion from one platform to another. Expect some slowdowns for sure. Okay, it's finally loaded. How about YouTube? Is it actually gonna load this one? No, doesn't seem to be. I guess it's super slow, it's just like not able to handle stuff very well. If you need some specific application, x86 application, and if you want to run this one in the virtual machine, I think this is the solution to go. In the next videos, I'm actually gonna try to install Windows XP in the UTM and see how it works. So far, I can say that it's probably not gonna be great. Like, once you install more apps, once you start using this one, oh my gosh, guys, it's probably not gonna be the best. But let's actually go ahead and see what kind of settings we have for this virtual machine. Settings, edit. Alright, so system, x86-64, memory, okay, 500 MB. Probably we should bump this one, but this is totally fine for the React OS, it's not that bad. What about advanced settings? Okay, CPU, number of cores, we can just basically customize all that stuff. And as you can see, QMU, machine properties. So yeah, you can basically customize that. Debug login, what other stuff we have? Guys, if you want to actually try this one without the front end, if you want to use a QMU just directly, this is like all the options you need to provide here. So basically you need to provide all the options in the command line. And I mean, it's quite manageable as possible, but again, it's just so much nicer just to have a front end like UTM, for example. So if you go to drives, you can see the disk image and you can see what, like, so basically it's like a hard drive and some disk, removable disk image. Display, full graphics and emulated display card. Okay, you can basically play with those options here. I think it's actually possible to like accelerate this one. Input, network, network is enabled, network works. Sound and sharing. And what about sharing? Clipboard sharing. Okay, so UTM is actually really, really good solution because it uses the QMU as a backend. And actually, let me prove it to you that actually is a good solution. When you press plus and you select start from scratch, you go to system, you select architecture. Guys, so this is all architecture it basically provides. For example, the PowerPC, PowerPC 64, and there are much, much more. Of course, you're gonna be using mostly x86 or x86-64. x86-64 is probably the best one to use. But if you need to emulate PowerPC, for example, I want to try to install macOS Tiger or macOS Leopard on this machine and see how it works. Probably it's gonna work. I hope it's gonna work. So for that, I'm gonna use this option right here. So this is how actually UTM works. Let's explore other solutions. Are there any other options available? Yes. And if you take a look here, you can actually see that there are other options. For example, you can use directly QMU to emulate stuff. And this is not my preferred method because, I mean, it involves a bunch of manual kind of interactions with the system, but you can try that. For example, first you just need to install the Xcode tools, Xcode select install. Then you need to use the homebrew, the package manager homebrew. I actually have a video about that one. And you can install QMU here. Then you need to create disk image. And for that, we're actually gonna use the QMU image create command. And you can just specify the size, like 10 GB, for example. Then you can actually run the VM and you can provide the path to the disk image. For example, it's gonna be ISO file of, ISO file of Windows XP, let's say. But in this case, the platform selected is System PowerPC. All those binaries after you install this one using the homebrew are actually available in this directory. And if you go to this directory, for example, like that, you can see what's available here. And you can see QMU, System, ARM, QMU System, M68K, MIPS, and whatever, like many, many options, PowerPC, PowerPC 64. And you can basically use those to launch the images very easily. So you just use this command right here, just specify what kind of BIOS you need, what drive you need to boot from and all that. But again, everything needs to be done manually to actually use this one. I do not recommend this method because it involves too much stuff, but I mean, if you want, you can just like play around with this one, because this one is actually, you are interacting with hypervisor itself without any front end. But there are more options available actually. For example, the ACVM right here I have, you can just go on the GitHub page again, you can download this one. And again, this one is just the front end for QMU. Let me actually show it to you. So after you launch ACVM, you just basically drop the image right here. You just drop the main image right there and you drop the CD image. And then you press start and you just specify the number of cores and the RAM. Start and you're gonna see basically it's all executed just fine. So this is like much more simpler comparing to UTM. And in my experience, it's not that great, because I mean, I had some problems with it. You cannot specify much stuff here. The BIOS, for example, like how you're gonna specify the BIOS, like other option drives and all that. It's very, very kind of like very, very simple, but at the same time, there's like no customizations at all. So basically, it's confusing. One more thing I wanted to discuss, like for example, how to know that this specific application uses the QEMU as a backend. It's very easy actually, in most of the cases. For example, the ACVM that we just discussed, you just right click on this one, show package content, then you go to resources, then you're gonna find the BIOS actually. It's just basically the folder which has all the BIOSes here, and then you're gonna find QEMU AMJ and QEMU System R64. So the main drawback of this application of the ACVM is that it only allows you to run ARM64 images, so no x86, nothing. So basically it's just limited to one platform. So again, this one limits this one to only ARM64. Kind of configurations. What else is available? There's also one more option available, which is called Toy VM, and actually have it right here as well. This one, I have not actually used this one, guys, so sorry, I have not tried this one yet, because there are so many options that I'm fine with whatever we have right now, but let's see. This one is actually using Apple Virtualization Engine, as far as I understand. So basically, it's not using QEMU as a backend, but it uses Apple Virtualization Framework, which is specified right here. So you can actually just follow this installation guide provided on his page. He actually has all the installation provided right here. All you need to do is basically install the Xcode and then follow those instructions. It's very easy. So you just create the build and you can run your images. I mean, if you guys are actually curious about this one, we can also discuss that option, but I feel like it's okay just to use a QEMU provided options. Maybe this one is gonna be faster, we'll see. But again, this one seems to be also limited to ARM64. If our intent is to run x86 applications, x86 images, then we cannot just use this one. So yeah, so we discussed the virtualization engine, but how about all other stuff? For example, there are two more things I wanted to discuss. So the first one, you're probably like curious, is DOSBox actually running fine here or not? Let's actually go ahead and check this out. So if I launch DOSBox, it just works just fine like that. If you look at the properties of the application, it says application Intel. So this one basically uses the Rosetta 2 to convert all the instructions from Intel x86 to your M1 chip. Intel to ARM transition is happening. In theory, it basically should slow down the machine, but guys, I mean, what kind of applications you're gonna be running in your DOSBox, right? It's mostly gonna be some simple applications. For example, I have Windows installed right here, Windows 3.1. It has the sound, but for some reason, it has this yellow kind of background on everything, so probably I just need to see if I need to change some configuration or stuff like that, but it actually works fine. For example, I can launch applications. It seems to be quite slower comparing to using DOSBox on your Intel Mac, for sure. That's what I see. Yeah, guys, you can definitely feel it actually slower, because probably we need to wait for the universal kind of binary of DOSBox to actually allow us to run everything like more or less natively with less conversion. But as you can see, it's kind of slow. It's a bit slow. I mean, and it should not be slow, because like Windows 3.1 was released like when? In the beginning of the 90s, right? Early 90s. So it should not happen like that. And one more thing I wanted to discuss is ShipShape. I have it right here. It's a macOS plus PowerPC kind of emulation tool. So it basically allows you to run macOS 9 in a window on your M1 machine. And I wanted to check it out and see how it goes. So I basically just copied everything from my Intel Mac. And for some reason, when I try to start it, it just says this. Basically, it's corrupted, the application is corrupted and it cannot start. So probably I just need to modify some stuff on the binary itself to run this one on the ARM. It seems like it's just like, I don't know, for some reason it's just restricting this one. As you can see, it has macOS 9.04 image right here, and it actually should start, and it also has the macOS 9 ROM, which basically it should work. It works totally fine on my Intel machine, but for some reason here I'm not able to start macOS 9 yet. I just looked at the forums just to see what other people are saying, and people are saying that this actually should work just fine. I think something is just like wrong with my machine right now. I just need to figure this out. It should be possible to run your macOS 9 on a ShipShaver, as far as I understand. Alright guys, so those are the options available for you if you want to run x86 virtual machines on your M1 Mac, and not only x86, but also like PowerPC or just ARM64, like as I said, like Debian or Ubuntu. Those are the options available for you. You can just like play around with those and see how it works for you. We are moving into the right direction, and we're gonna see more and more options available. VMware probably gonna provide us with something. They should provide with something, otherwise they like they're out of the business on the Mac, which is not great. Parallels is the main one I recommend using right now, and there are more based on QEMU, as I said. Just try all those and see how it works for you. But just a disclaimer, guys, before you try by all that, it's better to back up your own data, and I'm not responsible for any like damages to your computer, because who knows, all those are like beta solutions, nothing is proven. We're just like playing around with those and seeing how it works. Like M1 platform is like a beta platform. We still have so many things to fix here, so many new applications will be available and more solutions, so we'll see. Alright guys, thank you for watching this video. There will be more videos available. Just stay tuned, subscribe to my channel, press the like button if you like this video, because I took some time to basically analyze the market and see what's available here, so it actually took some effort. In the future, we're gonna discuss more, and probably I'm gonna try installing Windows XP on my M1 chip. So let's see how it works. Maybe Windows XP gonna be working just fine, who knows. Alright guys, bye!